One, two, three, hello. I think anybody is legitimate to have a political message. If you're a citizen of humanity, I think you're legitimate to have a political message. But I think it requires introspection, you know, the same way that we critique, you know, actresses for calling themselves feminists and then taking on roles that aren't feminist, or models feminists and then doing things which aren't, you know, everything is an evolution. So you start out and you can set the bar wherever you want and then hopefully get better and better. Everything we do is political, right? It's just a question of whether or not we admit that it's political. You know, when people say, oh, I'm just not that political, I think every decision you make is political. It's just a choice of whether or not you see the impact. And the same way around, like, gender politics, we make a choice every day. We make a choice when we dress women a certain way and put them in front of a camera. That's a political choice. We can just decide whether or not we see it that way. I think it is problematic to treat activism as a trend, but I think we also are in a moment where we need to onboard a lot of people and have empathy for people who are learning about activism. And I know for me, there are lots of things that I learned, and I did one way and then I did another way. One example is I had this green khaki jacket that looked sort of military. I think I got it at an army surplus store. And my partner said to me, you know, it's a funny thing to wear when you're photographed. Like, you don't want to celebrate violence. You don't want to make the military look like a cool thing, you know? And I really felt that he was right. And I stopped wearing that and I spoke up on shoots. Like, if we had camo, I would say, you know, we shouldn't be celebrating this. The same way I don't want to celebrate smoking. I think we have to be thoughtful about the images that we put out. And another great example is cultural appropriation. You know, that word, when I started in fashion, I hadn't heard that word. And I definitely wore things that today would not say yes to wearing. And I had to learn what that was. So social media is so interesting and complex in the world of activism because I think it's so powerful and valuable. But there's also this deepening that we have to work on. And I feel for myself, you know, there's so many things that I can say on social media that I feel like really confident because I know I'm right, I can say this. But when it comes to an interpersonal relationship, can I stand up for that on a shoot? Or do I, you know, have those values in my work life? Or do I say, oh, but this is like for money or this is with someone important, so I'm not gonna say anything. And so I think it's really like, it's so important to learn to speak up and to educate ourselves. And social media is really brilliant for that practice. But we also have to figure out how do we do that in person. So I saw this artist, and I wish that I could remember their name right now, who had edited the cover. And instead of saying How a March Becomes a Movement, it said How a March Joins a Movement. And I think that is a really good mentality to have right now, because a lot of people are waking up to political activism. We're seeing suddenly that it's really necessary, but we don't have to make up what we do next. There's, like, you know, tons of activists and movements that have gone on for, you know, decades and hundreds of years. And so I think we can join those movements, which is a nice way to understand that evolution, I think. You know, I actually, for a while, I kind of thought, okay, I have my activism outside of fashion and I have activism inside of fashion. The older I get and the more experience I have, I think those things are the same. Is that an answer?
Yes.